Hello, fellow occupational therapists. My name is Ollie, and today I'm going to introduce and provide an explanation for how to complete the DSI presentation project that is an assignment for you within the Capstone 1 course at Gannon University. So, to begin, we're going to take a look at two examples that I have and determine what is relevant within those projects. So I'm just going to show some key features. This would be a pretty quick video just to get you an overview of what to present, since you're going to present this two times within your semester. So let's get started. So to begin, we're going to be looking at the reasons to perform this project. So primarily what you're trying to gather from performing this assignment is you're presenting ideas within a doctoral specialty internship done by another occupational therapy doctorate student, and take the ideas they had that's similar to yours, or even if they're a little different from yours, formulate your thoughts, brainstorm, and try to come up with a good example for what you would want to do yourself. So maybe you liked a certain presentation that had a certain program that you desired, or maybe it will give you a better structure of how you're supposed to organize your time throughout your 14-week internship. So to give you a sort of a more concrete presentation, I'm going to present two examples that I performed during this course just to give you an idea of what to look for. So let's get started. So here's the first one. So this presentation was regarding neuroplasticity and martial arts, and it was performed by Brianna DeCooper. So my second slide within this is a summary. So you just want to get an overall synopsis of what the student, in this case Brianna, did with their OTD DSI project. So in this case, the study was performed within Nashville, Tennessee. You can even state what organization it was in. I indicated the goals that they were intending to complete, as well as the needs assessment, which is important to include. Both goals, objectives, and needs assessment are important to include within the summary page or within each of these examples. It's an imperative part. So you're looking at what the student got as a result of their research. So within this example, the student looked at neuroplasticity as affecting the environment, age, experience, intensity of experiences, and duration, while the central nervous system development was affected as well. So the student basically looked at neuroplasticity and the central nervous system development, and what they found was that neuroplasticity was affected by the environment, age, experiences, intensity of experiences, and duration. There is a modified bottom-up pyramid that illustrates the connection between one's experience and neuroplasticity. So those are the primary details I included. So that was primarily what I found throughout the study as relevant to include within this presentation. So you don't have to have a whole page of things, you know. You just want to keep it as concrete and focused as possible and look at parts of the study or the DSI project that are intriguing to you. Other relevant aspects of the literature review that I included were the reflex integration and martial arts as a modality. So let's take a look. Reflex integration involves the full inhibition of primitive reflexes. So you just kind of get like an idea of what they discovered by going through their studies. And martial arts as an interventional approach, they determined that it advances attention, behavioral management, postural security, adjustment, vestibular modulation, and proprioception. So this is just like a little sum up just to give you an idea of what it looks like. So within the doctoral specialty internship, outcomes are measures that you would use as a student to determine how much progress you've made within your DSI project. So within the doctoral specialty internship, you will need an outcome measure that helps determine how far you've progressed towards your objectives and your goals. So it's just basically a measuring tool to figure out where you're at in terms of from the beginning of your 14 weeks towards the end. So within this example, the student used a scoping literature review with martial arts as a value. The needs assessment data report was used as a measuring tool for summarization of the results. The student determined that the needs assessment that they performed initially, as well as the summarization of results, were used for the outcome measures. There was a community resource handout that was available within martial arts schools, And finally, the student had a martial arts flashcard program that helps to cement what they performed during this DSI. So after the outcomes have been stated, I decided to include why I chose this DSI. So this is one of the biggest parts of performing this assignment. You want to find out, why did you choose this DSI over another DSI that might be a little different, something that appealed to you? So within this example, I found the DSI interesting because it decided to blend an unused resource, which is martial arts, along with validity or evidence-based practice within the current literature. I find that it provides an inspiration for furthering different programs that aren't traditionally occupational therapy based, and including occupational therapy within settings that aren't normally as such. Finally, if you desire, it's usually nice to see what the poster looks like. Usually it will be pretty apparent how they categorized it, so that'll help you in determining how you want to organize your own poster. Now, in regards to different sections, everyone's poster is going to look a little different. So you just want to try to include various aspects I'll be listing towards the end of this video. So that was the first example. The second example looks at developing a health promoting program for individuals that are older adults within the community-based setting. So let's get started. So this project was performed by Antoinette Allen at Belmont University. So I decided to look at the summary to get a broad idea of what the student performed, or what they were intending to perform, and what their goals and objectives were. So the goals in this case were indicating a sustainable program that supports and empowers the community members through educating older adults or self-managing chronic conditions. The student goes into detail discussing each month and what it primarily looks at. So for example, you have February with heart health, and you have June as Alzheimer's disease. And I included why I like the project at the bottom. So this is a little different from the initial project example that I gave. This one has everything kind of summed up on one page. I just decided that was a better way to present it, and you can just do it the way you desire. So in this case, I included the summary, which is basically the whole project. I included the in-depth look of how they performed it. So each month there's a specific aspect to be knocked out or focused on. And finally, why I chose that assignment. So in this case, I primarily chose it because it was looking at novel approaches for a community-based setting. I enjoy working in a community-based setting, or that's where I plan to work within the far future whenever I'm practicing as an occupational therapist myself, as well as working within the older adults community or demographic, which is my ideal environment. So I liked it because I'm relevant to that demographic. I've worked in that demographic. I've liked being in the community. So here I just decided to show a visual aid in regard to how each month was divided into a specific health theme and activity, as well as each month having additional pamphlets or visual cues for community members. Now, you can choose to include this as well. It's not necessarily required, but it's kind of nice to get a better view when you're explaining the DSI project. So here I'm going to show what the student performed day by day, their exact sort of program, or an example of one day going through each aspect of it. So you can choose to include this within your doctoral specialty internship presentation. You can choose to bring in the instructions for recreating this project, or maybe even improving it. So this student decided to present a pamphlet or a sort of instruction guide for what is required to perform this project, usually given towards the employees of a certain organization for them to conduct a heart healthy, let's say a heart healthy sort of session or health promotion event. So in this case, let's take a look at what it looks like. So we have the musical chairs group protocol, and the student provides a rationale for it. You have the group goals, which is to perform at least 30 minutes of physical exercise to promote heart health. And then you have the warm-up activity, the musical chairs, how the members are selected, characteristics, the environment. So all those different aspects are included. So again, this is presenting the overall structure that the student decided to go with. You don't have to present it the same way, but if you enjoyed the method of presentation, you may include this as well. So you have the introduction, the mission statement that is done by the organization they were at. So this would be the Metro Parks and Recreation Organization within Nashville, Tennessee. You have the site challenges, goals of the experiential component, the outcomes, of course, the actual conducting of the study, and you can include any acknowledgments as well. So out of these two DSI examples, what do you need to present for yourself? What is most important to show? So you want to talk about what the doctoral specialty internship was aiming to achieve. So what was the needs assessment, the goals and objectives, as well as look at the literature review. What did they get out of their literature review? So how do you determine how far the student has come from the first week to the 14th week of their internship? This can be conducted in the way of how many people responded to their survey, or perhaps the survey itself. What kind of manifestation did they get? So in the case of program development, you would say maybe a manual or some kind of physical paper copy or instruction guide for maybe an organization's employees to be safer, let's say. In the case of the example, it was martial arts flashcards as well as a poster. So it'll vary based on what you're looking to do, but you want to include the outcome measures for sure. And finally, you just want to include, what did the student find out about their study? Was it successful? Was it somewhat successful? Was it kind of a different outcome than they wanted? And just, you can include any acknowledgments as well. So thank you for taking the time to listen through this video. I hope it was helpful for you. And just to remember to look for something that you enjoy, because when you're performing the doctoral specialty internship, it's what your passion is about. So hopefully you'll find something that you enjoy and you'll be able to present it to your classmates. Take care, everyone, and I'll see you in the next video.